Hello everyone, welcome to the Share Moment Diagram. Okay, Share Moment Diagram. So here we have beam, 10 meter span. It has 30 kilonewton load, 2 meters away from A. So point A, point B, and point C. We already solved the reactions. Reaction RC is 56 kilonewton and RA is 24 kilonewton. We check the reactions there. Submission vertical force is equal to 0, RA plus RC plus 30 minus 100, 74 plus 76 minus 130 equals 0. 0 here is equal to 0. Magnitude of this load, the uniformly distributed load, 10 kilonewton per meter, is 10 times 10 is 100 kilonewton applied to the midspan of 10 meters. So therefore, it's 5 meter there, 5 meter over here. Point B to C is 8 meters. We need that later on. So now let's solve for the shear. Let's begin at shear at A. Shear at A, right here. Shear at A is 4 kilonewton, the reaction. And then we have to locate that point there along the line, the vertical line of A. So 4 is right here. And now we have shear at A now, so shear at B, there are two shear at B, so this is B, two here, B1 and B2 at B, okay, so shear at B1, shear at B1 is RA, reaction A is a beta 4 times the load right here. When you do a shear, you have to stop wherever there's a load coming down. So you have to stop there. And at that point there, the B, so that's a B1, B2. So it's a B1 is 74, the reaction A minus 2 times 10. The uniformly distributed load is 10 kilonewton per meter times 2. But that's 20. So 74 minus 20 equals 54. So we have to locate the 54 kilonewton along the line of the B. So we have the B there. And then to draw the shear, the shear diagram is to draw that line there from A to B1. Now solve for B2. B2 is B1. B2 is B1 minus the load, concentrated load that's coming down, minus that, so it equals B2 is about 24 kilonewton. So there's 24 kilonewton along the line of along this line here. So B2 is 24 kilonewton, this is 24. That point here, so that is 54, 24 is about this point here. So now to draw the shear diagram, and since this is concentrated load, you gotta draw the line vertical to B2 from B1. Draw that line there. So there's the B2 there. Now, shared C. Shared C is B2. B2 there minus all the loads here. From here. From B to C, that is 10 times lever arm 8. The span is 8. So 8 times 10 is equal to 80. And 24 minus 80 is minus 56. To add two numbers having a like sign is to take the difference between these two and retain the sign of a greater number. And in this case, it is 80 as it's a greater number, so retain that sign. So we get negative 56 at C. So locate at C the 56 point there along the vertical line of C. So that's 74, right? So 56 is around here. Okay, this is 56 minus 50. It's minus 56, and to draw the shear diagram is to draw the shear diagram is to connect B2 to the line 56. It's inclined line. So that's the shear diagram for C. Okay, now we have all the shear completed there. We have 54 B1, B2 is 24, and shear at C is minus 56. Now to solve for the moment, we need an area. We need an area, all the areas here. This is area 1. Area 1 is a triangle. Area 1 is a triangle. And the height of the triangle there, this is 54 minus 74. 74 minus 54, that's 20. So the height of this triangle here is 20. And the base is 2 meters. So area of the triangle is 1/2 base times height. Cancel the two there, so therefore A1 is 20. Kilonewton meter. A1 is 20 kilonewton meter. Now the next area is here. Area 2 is a triangle. The height of the area 2 is a rectangle. The height of the rectangle there is 54. See that you draw this line here, separating the triangle and the rectangle. So the height is 54 and the base is 2. This is 2 meters. Is 2 meters, and therefore the area 2 now is 54 times 2. 54 times 2, 2 is equal to 108 kilonewton meter. It's 20. Now area 3. This is area 3. Area 3, the height of the triangle there for area 3 is 24, and we don't know. It's 24, and we don't know the base for this area 3 triangle right here. We know it's the height is 24, but we don't know the base, so we have to solve that by using similar triangle. This is an X, we don't know. Put that an X for now. So
So for X, we have to use the similar similar triangle. So for H, you have to use similar triangle. To do the similar triangle, you have to start with your denominator of the denominator of your fraction there to have the equation. So X be horizontal, you have to use the horizontal first, the horizontal distance X and the horizontal distance. Since we are solving this triangle here, this big load here, the uniformly distributed load there, from B to C, that is the triangle of consideration. So we gotta start the horizontal distances first. So horizontal distance X divided by 8. This one here. This is 8. It's 8 meter. It's equal to the height of the triangle, the small triangle first. You gotta start with small. Okay, the small horizontal and the small vertical. Small. This is 24. The height of this is 24 up to here. So it's 24 divided by now the total height is 24 plus 56, that's 80. 24 here to here, the total height, that is 56 plus 24 is 80. X now is 8, because there cross multiply this 8 times 24 divided by 80, X is equal to 24 times 8 divided by X equals to 2.4 meters. So X there is 2.4 meter. And this distance here we need that distance there. This is X. This is 8, up to here is 8, this is 8 minus X, so therefore this is 8 minus 2.4 is 5.6, that's 5.6 meters. Now area 3 is a triangle, so the height here is 24 and the base is 2.4, so therefore area 3 is 1 half times 2.4 times 2.4 times 24. Area 3 equal to 28.8 area 3 is 28.8 kilo newton meter. Okay, now area 4, area number 4, area 4. Area 4 is also a triangle and the height, this height here is 56 and the base is 5.6, so it's equal to 1 half. Area
36 times 56 and area 4 is equal to minus, that's negative. This is negative here, 56. So 5.6 times 56, that is 156.8. 156.8 kilonewton meter. And it's minus. Alright? Now solve for moment. We have everything in the area, and now solve for moment. Moments. Okay, moment A, right here, is equal to zero, always start at the zero. Moment A is equal to zero. Now, moment B1. Moment B1 is area 1 plus area 2. Area 1 plus area 2 is equal to what's area 1? It's 20. 20 plus area 2 is 108 kilonewton meter. Moment B1. B1 is equal to 128 kilonewton meter. So we have B1 now. Moment B2. This is B1. And this is B2. Is equal to the moment B2 is moment B1 is 128 plus area 3 is equal to 128 plus the area 3 there. Area 3 is 28.8. Moment B2 is equal to 128 plus 28.8 plus the minus is equal to 156.8 kilonewton meter. Okay, now let's plot this. From zero, draw the moment diagram. You have to use the curve, second degree line. So this is the 128 is right here. And 156 is approximately right here. Now you draw a curve from here to zero. Right there, that's your from moment B2, B1. This is B1. And moment at zero at A. So now moment at C. Moment that C should be equal to zero, or else we're wrong. So moment at C is equal to moment B2
plus the moment A4, which is negative,
so become minus
156.8 is equal to positive 156.8 minus 156.8. Moment at C now is equal to zero. Once it's zero, then all the calculations here are correct. So now we draw the zero points right here. You see. And get a lot right there. I forgot something, the piece above. The shear the shear at B sub O is equal to the shear BC. The shear BC is negative plus R C. So shear V sub O is right here. It should be zero. Right there, that shear there. It should be zero or else something wrong with the calculations there. So what is BC? BC is minus 56. And the RA is positive. 56 kilonewton. So therefore, shear at V sub O there is equal to zero. So you got everything correct there, the shear and the moment. So that's how you draw the shear moment diagram. There we go, that's the shear moment diagram, and that's the end of the video, and thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, thank you.